Stay tuned at the end of the episode, guys, for a special announcement. How's it hanging today, Sugoi boys and Sugoi girls? I'm your host, Tova the Survivor, and this is another catastrophe of an episode of Not So Sugoi. I just decided that I was gonna skateboard into work today. You know, it was appropriate for the subject of the episode. Considering how today we're gonna be talking about a renowned skateboarding franchise of games that everybody knows and cherishes. A franchise of games from the 90s that nobody can ever forget if you were alive during that time. Something that we all remember to this very day. The one and only franchise that everybody thinks of when they think of skateboarding video games. That's right, guys. Today, finally on Not So Sugoi, we are covering the one and only Street Skater for the PS1.
Whoosh.
It's safe to assume that Street Skater didn't have very many examples to go off of skateboarding games that came out at the time, except Top Skater. It's like that weird kid in the back of your second grade class who likes to shove all the macaroni into the wrong orifices on his body while you're supposed to be making macaroni art with paste. So without further ado, guys, let this beautiful anime boy, anime girl, get confused about which gender they are for the next few minutes of your life, and let's talk about Street Skater for the PS1.
Mario.
Fuck you.
3, 2, 1,
you.
Hit it!
Come on, yeah!
Street Skater is a very simple game to get into and play. It's not very hard to learn, but yet at the same time, it has this absolute depth of mastery about it that you have to truly grasp your brain and wrap it around it to understand exactly what is Street Skater? What is the life of Street Skater? What is it like actually being a skateboarder? You're basically playing the Dark Souls of skateboarding games right here, the original. Each playthrough of the game includes 3 stages and 2 bonus stages. The bonus stages happen between the ends of stage 1 and the end of stage 2. The first stage is a nightmare. There's not enough ramps or shit to do tricks off of. The second stage is far better and lenient in how many areas they want you to be able to do tricks in, and it's fun, and it's also... Did I just say this game was fun?
You're ripping! Sick move! Sick move!
The third stage kind of dials it back a bit and wants it to be more paced. I feel like out of all the stages, they must have spent the most time on this one because a lot of the ramps don't look like they're fucking randomly placed and dumb as shit. I feel like this course takes most of its influence from Top Skater, which I mentioned earlier this game bears many similarities to in the term of its aesthetic. How are expert tricks pulled off in this game? How do you bust a fat nut? How do you bust a fat trick? It's easy, guys. Roll yourself up to a ramp, and you hit the X button, and that's it. Can you fall off your board? Can you bail? Do you get to beef it like the squid? Yes, if you hit a wall. That's it. Or if you hit X too late when jumping off the ramp. I guess they decided it'd be a good mechanic that if you smash the X button and miss the lip of a ramp that you'd also bail as well. You're almost always going to jump off the ramp and execute a trick since the ramps are like a mile fucking wide. It's not really difficult to do it. The entire trick system in this game has no learning curve at all. You will struggle more with the physics in this game than the actual trick system. Going up the ramp, turning is not even an option. When you come down from the ramp, turning is almost almost not even an option. Trying to maneuver on the ramp at all, other than hitting X and going straight up it, is almost no option. It's never an option. Don't even fucking try it. It's not worth it. So let's say you can stomach one entire playthrough of this game. Well, then you get more points to upgrade your character, and then you can move on and keep playing the same skater. Then they expect you to move on to another skater, level them up, do the same thing, level up another skater, and do the same thing. You guys get the idea. You then begin unlocking new stuff, including getting gates open, even though I don't know why you'd want to do this dumb shit on the first course. Who fucking came up with this level design? Beating the game two times with a single skater will unlock two different things, followed by, I think, secret skaters or boards and shit like that. You could unlock a ninja. Microcabin had the fantastic idea of reskinning the kid with the hat as a chimpanzee. He has the exact same moveset. He looks almost exactly the same in his animations. He is the same size. I don't know what they were fucking thinking, man. I'm not making this shit up. They actually fucking did this. Like, I'm not trying to be racial here, but that's kind of fucking weird and rude and awkward that they reskinned him as a monkey. Microcabin, what the fuck is wrong with you, man? I decided to reach out to Microcabin after finding their email address on their website. I decided that I'd ask them a couple questions and see if maybe they'd be up for an interview of some kind. In true not-so-Sugoi fashion, I delivered on getting an interview. So, I'm interested. Just when exactly did you come up with the idea for Street Borders on the PlayStation 1, also known as Street Skater in North America?
I was a young adult in the early 90s. I would visit my favorite manga cafe in Akihabara. It was there that I discovered, and began reading, a lesser-known sports manga by the name of Doki Doki Suke Tobodo Hayaku. That was definitely my main inspiration for wanting to make Street Borders.
Was there quite possibly a shorter nickname that it had gone by in the West or online that we might know it more fondly as?
If I do remember correctly, it is also abbreviated as Doki Squared Suke To.
Now, I understand that the 90s were quite some time ago, but if you could, would you be able to recollect what was the general plot of this manga?
The hero went by the name of Yu Hayato. His father was a scientist who was murdered after making a skateboarding-related discovery that could change Japan forever. He leaves Kyoto to live in Tokyo, and finds clues as to why his father was killed. He begins to compete professionally in downhill skateboarding events, and has a mysterious rival who always wears a red, full-faced helmet. He also happens to start attending the very same high school that his Osana Najimi goes to as well! But he must keep skateboarding a secret from everyone else, especially his senpai, who he respects. Annie Azumeka.
And I just want to say thank you so much today for allowing me this opportunity to interview you, Mr. Microcabin. It's been a pleasure. It's been a real honor, and as they say in our great homeland of Nippon, onigiri gozaimasu. But guys, I just want to say thank you guys for watching this episode of Not So Sugoi. I'll see you guys later.
Yo, we just hit over 1,000 subs.
What?
Alright guys, we did it. 1,000 subscribers. We're deep in this now, Sugoi boys and Sugoi girls, and I actually just want to say thank you for watching, for all the recent people who have subscribed to my channel and have come here from Sea Dog. Bless that beautiful anime boy. Love him. I appreciate that shout out he put me in. The fact that he basically shouted me out at the beginning of the video embarrassed me so much. Like, holy shit. But anyways, we've got a 1,000 subscriber special to take care of now, guys. You guys have to vote. We have an entirely new thing dawning on the horizon of this channel. And the fate of it is in your hands. You get to pick anything you want. Anything. Upvote. Downvote answers. Abuse your answers. Abuse the voting system. I don't care how you do it. But my God, I want to see that shit fill up in a few weeks. I'm going to give it 2 to 3 weeks, guys. I'll cut it off whenever. If it looks like we're just sitting at the top of some glorious gold mine of beautiful content for the final answer with hundreds of votes more than another answer, I'm probably gonna pick that. But go vote today, guys. Once again, the 1,000 subscriber special is in your hands. What the fuck is up, guys? How's it hanging? And I hope everybody is safe. I hope everybody's practicing social distancing.
I hope this COVID-19 bullshit doesn't have you being driven insane, because trust me, I think I know what I'm saying when I mean that I know what insane truly is, and that's these three beautiful bastards backing me on Patreon. We have the Nine Dogs, Un Colant, and we have Nicholas Blair. Three beautiful individuals who have stepped up to the call of duty and have put their support and their faith in me at the exact same time. I'm not sure how that's possible, but it is. But if you too would like your name at the end of these videos, as well as many others I'm going to try to put out, then you could do that by backing just $1 on our Patreon today for Sugoi Variety Hour. And also, do not forget to vote for the 1,000 subscriber special. The link is in the description. Go check it out, guys. You can nominate the subject of a not-so-Sugoi episode for the 1,000 subscriber special. You can also upvote and downvote any of those nominations. I hope to see you guys there. And bless that beautiful anime boy, C-Dog VA, because none of you guys would be watching this right now if he hadn't have done that big shout-out for me. Let's face it, that's the only reason you're here. So until then, fuck my ass, fuck my life, I'm out of here.